Welcome back to Engineering Graphics class. In this session, we will discuss how to solve the projection of solids problem using Solid Edge software. Okay, let me discuss the problem number 50. A cone of base dia 40 mm and axis length 50 mm is resting on HP on a point on the circumference of its base such that its apex is at 40 mm above the HP and its top view of the axis is inclined at 60 degree to VP. Draw the top and front views of the solids. Also determine the inclinations of the axis when the base is near to the observer. So as well, first we will take the normal line and draw the horizontal line, and then one end of the line we can make it as X and other end Y. And above XY line VP and below XY line HP. Okay, next they given the shape, the cone is given, resting condition we don't know, need to worry about. We have to start from the HP cone, and the diameter they given 40. So we can enter the diameter 40, and this line should be visible, so you can directly take visible line and 40, and we can place it in HP. Okay. And the next furthermost next thing we can we need to divide the circle, we need to divide the circle to make the points on the circumference. So we can use the option circular pattern. To do that, first we need to draw a horizontal line from center to the periphery, like a radius we have to draw a line, and next select this line and then go to pattern option. Here circular pattern we have to select, and then click on the center. And here we need to make a count. Normally we divide into 8, and then throughout 360 degree it should be divided. So we have to enter and then finish. See, like the circle is divided. After dividing, so we can give the namings. So we can zoom this for a better view option. We can start it here, periphery only one. A naming, there is no two edges comes here. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H, and center apex O and bottom O1. So once we got it, then we need to get the front view from all these corners. We need to draw a normal line, projection lines to XY line, and then we can give the height with respect to center only, because always when come to the pyramids and cone, always we need to give the height along the center line. Here center line is here, so we can use the center line option. Height of the cone they given, length of the axis length 50 they given, so we have to take 50, and then only the borders we have to make it visible. Like this, we have to make borders visible, and the remaining lines we can just draw with a normal line. So that is to here, and from here to this is the point. And coming to the naming, so here this point only A is there, so that way A dash we can name it, and this point we are getting B and H, so B dash of H dash we can name it here, and this point we are getting C and G, so C dash of G dash, and then this point we are getting D dash of F dash, and the last one is E dash, and here O dash, and then this one here also we can get O1 dash. So all the namings here, the it is so overlapping, so we can keep it such that it should be clearly visible. Okay, next step, they given this apex. So here the bay, okay, such that the apex is 40 mm above HP. So now this apex is 40 mm above HP. Till that I need to make that apexes over here. For that first I will draw the reference line, horizontal line, and then I will give the distance for it from the XY. It should be 40 dimension. It should be 40. Like this we have to give it 40 mm we have to maintain. So after that, so we need to move it such that the resting point, the E will be on the XY line, but this apex should come on this 40 mm line, should touch the 40 mm line. So for that we have to go to move option, select all the lines including center and the bottom line, and then we need to pick from E, we need to pick from E, and we need to place it on the XY line like this. After moving, go to rotate option, select the entire object and make E is fixed as E dash, and this O dash rotating point. And before rotating, you can zoom this area and make sure it should be exactly on the 40 mm locus line. Like this, we have to rotate it. And after that, the namings, all namings can need to be moved. Go to move option and move the naming. This is E dash, and this one is D dash of F dash, and this is C dash of G dash. Next, B dash of H dash, and then A dash, and the last O dash. And now we go to normal line and do the projection and get the top view. We can start one by one. I will start from the A. So I will get the A, and A dash is here, and then here B and H. So this is the point we are getting B and B dash, and then H dash we can get it here, and then center, this is a C dash, okay. Next here from C dash and G dash we are getting on this point, and this one is, and get the G dash, and then D dash of F dash we are getting over here, and then here dash, and then E dash, and the last O dash. Okay, now we will move the namings first. So this is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. And now go to the ellipse by 3 points, because this will look ellipse by 3 points, and take a visible line. First point is a A, and second point is E, and third point we can take it as G. Like this, simple, by taking ellipse by 3 points we can finish this. And last, go to visible line and join the borders from G to O, and then C to O. We have to join it like this. And moreover, when it come to the thing, so here the first this, the sum of the portion is hidden here, because only the front portion is seen. That means here A, from the A, B, C is the visible, this is the portion is visible, and this is the second portion, it will become hidden because of the top face. It is coming under of this, and this portion will be coming hidden. So we have to make this one is hidden. How to make that partial hidden means, we can use the option split. Go to the split, select this line, and you can split at G as well as split at C. Then once you split that, see, this is become separate segment, and this one is separate segment. And now this one, so we can make it hidden line, and then thickness 0.5. Like this it should be made it. Okay, after making hidden, the central line, I forgot name, this is O1, and this one is O. And next step, they told the top view, so we can go back to question here. See the HP, the top view of the axis is inclined 60 degree to VP. Top view of the axis means we need to select the top view axis, that is OO1. That means directly they given this apparent length. So this OO1 is inclined to VP at 60 degree. So we need to make that OO1 60 degree. So no need to find beta angle because they not mention just axis. They mention top view of the axis. That means second step length only they given. So we can directly place it here. And you, we can take it any direction, this side direction or this direction you can take it. I will take it here, this side direction. So you can enter the angle 60 degree. And you can show it by using angle between option. Select this line and fix the angle 60. And now, so here to get the axis line, so we can use a, I will use a trim option and select this. We can join the next, go to center line and join from O to O1. Okay, now, so as we discussed here, the axis, top view of the axis O1, we have to place it here. So that is why we need to select. Before selecting that, we want these editing points. So that's why what I suggest means I will draw the normal lines, that is from A to E as well as F to B and then H to D, and this one already split it up. We will get the point notification here. No need to worry about that. And then go to move, select all the lines, axis line, and then these lines what we drawn here. Okay, next go to the point O, pick it and place it on the 60 degree line, and then go to rotate. Same way you can select this all the lines and then make this O fixed point, and then this is a rotating point, and make sure it should be come on this 60 degree line, and later we can move the namings. So this is O and this point is E and this point is F and this point is G and then H, A and then B and then C and then D and the last O1. And to final front view, to get that we will draw the projection lines from the top view and we will get one by one. Start with the A. So A is here, the A dash we are getting at the top here. So we can join up to here, get the A dash and then B. So we are getting the B dash is here, so we can draw the line up to here, get the B dash, and then C, C dash we are getting here, you can draw up to here and get the C, and then D dash. So E dash will be on the XY line, you can draw up to here, and then this is F dash and then G dash and then H dash. Center we can get it from here, O. So here we are getting O 1 dash and the last center we are getting here O dash. So first we will name it all the points. O dash, start with the A. So you have A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, and then this is F dash, G dash, and then H dash, and your O1 dash. Okay, now go to line, visible line here. This one we can't use the ellipse option, we can use the curve option. So select the curve option, and before starting the curve option we need to do one setting, that is go to tools, we need to switch off the maintain relationship. After switching off we can draw the curve. Okay, we are seeing from the bottom, and in the question also they given the observer, determine the inclination of the axis when the base is near to observer. They mentioned base is near to observer, so we have to keep the base downside, and we did that. And when we kept the base downside, so base, entire base is visible here, so we can make that, that is A to B to C to D, E, F, G, H and A. So we have to completely base, we have to make it visible, and then go to line and switch back this relationship, main relationship, and then periphery we have to join it, and then from here we can get to the A. Okay, after O to A, then here almost tangent we have to draw, so sometimes it will come up to the D, you can join up to here. Like this is enough for this, and center line last, go to line, center line from O1 dash to O dash, we have to draw the center line. And next, check the inclination observer to the, that go, we can go to the angle between option, select this line and select the XY line, that is the horizontal line. You can take this one also horizontal line is enough. So we can check the angle, so this is the angle we are getting, 45 degree, and you can check this one also, initially it is 26 degree. Okay, last, we need to keep the namings properly, any overlappings is there you can just keep it outside by switching off the copy option, because when we take the printout it should be looks all the points and all should be clearly visible, like that we have to place it and get the printout. Okay, all the thing is done, problem is completed.